what you came for. Lightning strikes every time she moves. All right, are we ready? Yeah! I can't hear you, are we ready? Yeah! All right, good evening everyone, and welcome to the historic Pioneer Theater reopening, and you are the guest right here. Give yourselves a round of applause for coming out tonight. Thank you so much to all the people, the staff here at the Pioneer. You don't understand how much work has gone into making this look as awesome as it is. It is so great to see each and every one of you. My name is Mr. Brian. I'm a teacher here at Manteo Middle School. I'm going to open up tonight, and I've got two gentlemen that are going to drive the show here this evening. I'm the one responsible for, ladies and gentlemen, there's a lot of us in here. If anything wrong goes on, we're going to the exits. And boys and girls, we are going to walk. We are not going to run. We got an exit right here, two in the back. I could be a flight stewardess, steward, whatever, it's good. All right, also at this time, your cell phones. Please take plenty of pictures. Just turn that ringtone off so that we can kind of focus on what we're doing up here. All right, so I was thinking, how do I want to open the show? And we have some zingers, as the kids up here like to talk about. Yeah, you, right there. So I do want to welcome our VIPs. We are here tonight because of the fine accomplishments of your children right here, up here in the front rows. They're our VIPs. Let's give them a round of applause this evening. All right, very nice. This is my third year at Manteo. The first year I came here, I came from Kitty Hawk. I came here, and one of the first Friday nights, I came and I sat in this theater. I sat in this theater with my wife, who's in the background right there, and it was so cool. I don't even remember the movie that we watched, but I never forget the first time when somebody said, "Ooh, there's Mr. Brian. Ooh, there's Mr. Brian." Yeah, you right there that raised your hand right there to look up to these two young men up here in the front that you're going to see a couple times tonight up here with some friends, boys and girls. Luckily, you guys are all sitting beside boys tonight, so I don't have to worry about your hands up here in the front right here in the good old Pioneer Movie Theater. But I broke the seal. All right, so with that being said, I just thought it was so cool here at Manteo Middle School that I was acknowledged as Mr. Brian out here as a good night by these two young men. My wife and I came back a couple times, and we thoroughly enjoyed it. When this place closed down, I felt something inside. I'm sure every one of you all that's been in this theater before can tell a story similar, or the guys up here in the front, similar to the last time you came in this theater, or the first time you came in this theater. It warms my heart that we are back here, and it's even cooler that we are doing something better than a movie. We're gonna make history tonight by handing out the Braveys. Now, I'd like you all to welcome to the stage our athletic director, Mr. Grady Edwards.
Thank you, Brian, for getting them nice and riled up for me here. Good evening. As assistant principal and athletic director at Manteo Middle School, I'd like to welcome parents, teachers, school community members, and most importantly, our student athletes to the third annual Bravey Awards. This year, we have the pleasure of hosting the Braveys in the newly renovated and reopened historic Pioneer Theater. In addition, for the first time ever, this year's Braveys will be live streamed, so we are officially worldwide as of tonight. I'd like to thank Superintendent Bassnight, district leadership, the technology department for making the streaming possible, and also thank you to Aaron Jennings, who has worked so graciously to help set up and record our live stream. I want to thank Jamie and David Hatchell, Sharon and Derek Hatchell, Vicky and Todd Herring, Denise Pierce, and Mr. Michael Bassnight and their team for their work, their tireless work to prepare this venue, and for their gracious hospitality. It's hard to believe, but this theater has stood here in this location for nearly 90 years. Think of all the history these walls have seen. There's no doubt on this special night, we will add to that history. For this is a special night. It is a night we remember and reflect on the past season, but also look to the opportunities of the future. It is a night where we celebrate our athletes and all they've accomplished this season. It's a night where we roll out the red carpet, quite literally, and treat our athletes like celebrities. Athletes, this night is for you. And I hope in some way is a thank you and recognition for the hard work you've put in this year. Each of you are very special to Manteo Middle School, this community. Although only some of you will receive Bravey trophies tonight, know that all of you are deserving, and I am very proud of each and every one of you. Before we begin the awards for this evening, I would like to thank some individuals or groups who make athletics possible at the school. I'd like to again recognize Pioneer Theater's team for allowing us to host this event here. I think I speak for everyone in attendance. Their venue is incredible, and we are so honored to be a part of the reopening. I'd like to thank Deputy Don Grover, Manteo Sheriff's Department, and Manteo PD for their attendance to our sporting events. Deputy Dawn was in attendance at nearly every game, and her support was greatly appreciated. I'd like to thank our teachers for filling in gate and concession duties throughout the year. Working these duties proves to be a long day, but our teachers do so happily. Thank you, teachers. I'd like to thank our custodial team, Mr. Bill Rainey, Mr. Nathan Smith, and Ms. Michelle Henley. In addition to keeping our school beautiful, they are often tasked with keeping our athletic facilities clean and orderly. Thank you for all that you do. I'd like to thank the parents and community members for their support throughout the season. Many of our parents provided meals for students prior to games at their own cost. Our parents are incredibly supportive and essential partners for our athletic programs. Athletes, as you reflect on this past year, take a moment to thank your parents for the dedication they've shown to you and to this school. I'd like to thank our wonderful coaches, many of whom are in attendance here tonight. We are very fortunate at Manteo Middle School to have knowledgeable and experienced coaches across our sports. Our coaches are great mentors and advocates for our student athletes. During the season, our coaches often spend more time with the players than they do their own families. Coaches, thank you for your time, dedication, and all that you do for Manteo Middle School. I'd like to specifically thank Mr. Coach Alexander, Roy Kent. In addition to being one-third of the best physical education department in the state, Coach Alexander regularly dedicated his time and energy to working with Manteo Athletics. We're lucky to have Coach Alexander at the middle school, and I feel very fortunate to call him a dear friend. I would like to thank Ms. Nicole Thrash. In addition to being an exceptional data manager at the school, Ms. Thrash is our athletic bus driver. Ms. Thrash drives in the morning as well, meaning her day often starts at 4 a.m. and ends very late on away games. Ms. Nicole also stocked the concession stand this year and is willing to go above and beyond for Manteo Athletics. Ms. Nicole's impact on Manteo Middle School cannot be overstated, and she has provided tremendous support to me with my duties as assistant principal and athletic director. Thank you, Nicole, for all that you do. I'd like to recognize Kim Dixon and Gracie Story for their assistance and support with our programs and tickets. Thank you, ladies, for all that you do. While there are far too many to thank by name here tonight, thank you to all who help support Manteo Athletics. As athletic director, I'm truly thankful to be part of a community who is willing to give so much. Thank you. Now I have the great honor of starting our award ceremony with the Student of the Year Award, the Student Athlete of the Year Award. Student athletes must pass all required coursework to be eligible for competition. Their grades must remain passing for the entirety of the season, and I'm very proud to say that over 80% of our athletes in attendance tonight have found themselves on the AB Honor Roll this year. Our student athletes embody what it means to be a Brave and an athlete at our school. The Student Athlete of the Year Award is given annually to the male and female with the highest GPA in each respective grade. Recipients of this award deserve special recognition as their talents extend far beyond the playing field and into the classroom. Are we ready for the first Bravey?
Yes, sir!
All right. When you're called, please come up and accept your award and remain up here for pictures. The sixth grade Student Athlete of the Year for sixth grade goes to Hurley Williams and George Parrott.
Hey, Trevor.
Now, seventh grade. The seventh grade, who said not me? The seventh grade Student Athlete of the Year goes to Bella Huntingford and Colton White. Colton White, it's you, buddy. Congratulations.
That last test you took on Friday changed it there, buddy. So good job there, Colton, before it updated.
Okay. Yeah. It was a very heavily weighted test there in seventh grade, apparently. The eighth grade Student of the Year. Please hold your applause until both names are called. Daisy Brewster and Jacob Shordecki.
Daisy must be studying yet.
Yeah, that's a good one. Daisy must be at home studying right now. Congratulations to those students. The next award tonight is the Perseverance Award. Coach Levi Curls was so kind to name this award in my honor last year, and I'm happy to be back again this year. This award is special to me because of all the many lessons athletics has taught me, I have relied on perseverance most frequently in my adult life. As many of the parents in the audience can attest, life, more often than not, has its share of hardships and trials. To persevere means to have discipline of the mind and body, to never give up, no matter the circumstances. I'm paraphrasing slightly, but Martin Luther King once famously said, "The true judge of a young man or a young woman is not at a time of comfort, but at a time of conflict and controversy." To persevere means to be willing to embrace challenges, to confront fear, and, if only by sheer will, accomplish the goal. I'm very pleased to present the nominations for Perseverance Award. The female nominees are Kimri Keith, Haley Stokes, Bella Huntingford, Adriana Cruz Gabriel, and Gabriela Aguirre Gomez. And I'm very pleased to say the Bravey for the Perseverance Award this year goes to Gabriela Aguirre Gomez.
Gabby participated in three sports this year: the soccer team, the wrestling team, and the track team.
The male nominees for the Perseverance Award. Nominees are Landon Davenport, Gage Walston, Nehemiah Gibbs, Tanner Sawyer, Jason Haley, and Brandon Gonzalez Herrera. I'm very pleased to present the Male Perseverance Award to Tanner Sawyer.
This is Tanner's first Bravey Award after being nominated several times, and he participated on the football team, the basketball team, and the baseball team.
All right, our next award is a special award, but before we go to it, I'd like to recognize Ms. Tammy Harper for her leadership and support throughout the year. I have worked at several schools in my time as an educator, but her dedication to Manteo Middle School stands out above the rest. Ms. Harper is tremendously supportive of athletics and very often is your biggest cheerleader. While she regrets not being able to be here tonight, she never misses a game or an event at Manteo Middle School. I'd like to thank Ms. Harper for her mentorship and support, and I feel very fortunate to serve as assistant principal under her leadership. In her honor tonight, I'd like to present the Tammy Harper Leadership Award. This award is given to the male and female athlete whose leadership extends to the playing field, classroom, and beyond. The female nominations for the Tammy Harper Leadership Award are Bailey Dickerson, Daisy Brewster, Charlotte Miller, Rihanna Bateman. And the female recipient of the Tammy Harper Leadership Award is P.D. Bateman.
P.D. is an eighth grader who participated in volleyball, basketball, and softball this season. She didn't play volleyball? She didn't do volleyball? She did last year. I'm coaching soccer. I don't know these things. I'm coaching soccer. I don't know these things.
Very excited to present the male nominations for the Tammy Harper Leadership Award. They are Jacob Shordecki, Bennett Jones, Drew Brown, Colton Worrell, Leif Worth, and Trevor Sawyer. And the winner, the male winner of the Tammy Harper Leadership Award, the Bravey goes to Trevor Sawyer.
Eighth grade Trevor participated in three sports this year as one of the best managers of the football team, basketball player, and baseball player. Get those pitchers. There you go.
All right, before we can continue with the student awards, I'm going to go a little rogue here, so y'all forgive me. And before I hand this over to Coach Curls, I'd like to thank Mr. Brian Wehner, Coach Wehner, the voice of the Braves. Brian, step out here. Stay right there. Jerry seems very excited up here. Brian is truly a Swiss Army knife at Manteo Middle School. You need a scoreboard run? Brian's your man. You need the flag put out because you forgot to? Brian's on it. You need a microwave because you blew up the one in the concession stand? Brian will wheel one in for you. Brian, Coach Wehner, all jokes aside, you are a tremendous asset to Manteo Middle School athletics, and I greatly appreciate all that you have done to help make this event and all Manteo athletic events possible. Let's please recognize Mr. Wehner and present him with a Bravey Trophy for all his contributions this year. Thank you, Mr. Wehner. There's another man I'd like to thank who happens to be on this stage. I'd like to thank our host and master of ceremonies for this evening, Mr. Levi Curls. You see, he's made an impact. In his relatively short time at Manteo Middle School, Coach Curls has made a huge impact on students and athletes alike. Those who have played for Coach Curls note the lasting impression he has made on their lives on and off the playing field. Coach Curls is a tremendous mentor for both young men and women, and I can think of no greater supporter of Manteo Middle School athletics than Coach Curls. In addition to coaching football, girls basketball, and baseball, Coach Curls is the man behind this night. And this night is a reflection of how he feels about this community and the admiration he has for our student athletes. As an administrator at the school, I feel incredibly fortunate to have a teacher, coach, role model, colleague, and dear friend in Mr. Levi Curls. With that said, and since I'm in charge for athletics for at least the rest of this evening, I thought I might make up my own award tonight, if you'll excuse me. What's in it? Coach Curls, I'd like to present you with the Coach Levi Curls Dedication Award. I'm making up an award since I'm athletic director. This award is presented annually, so we will give this every year, but you're the first recipient. This award is presented annually to the person who showcases an unwavering commitment and dedication to Manteo Middle School athletics. Winners of this award embody everything about what it means to be a Brave: service, dedication, and selflessness. Coach Curls, you deserve this award.
Never had a doubt.
Yeah, thank you, man. Yeah, I got one more thing here. And finally, I'd like to speak directly to our student athletes. Tonight, you are the celebrities, and each of you have dressed for the occasion. Although you are middle schoolers, looking out at all of you tonight, I'm reminded just how much you've grown up this year. They say middle school is where you find your identity, your sense of self. While I think some of you might still be looking, I am very proud of the work you've done this year and the students you've become. The greatest sense of pride I feel as an administrator is when I watch our young men and young women compete for Manteo Middle School. Throughout the year, each of you has dedicated your time and energy to something greater than yourselves. And for that, I am proud. More than three quarters of our students here tonight, in addition to your prowess on the playing field, are AB Honor Roll students. For your work in the classroom and your leadership in the school, I am proud. Many of our teams had winning records. Our wrestling team had an individual champion. Our softball team was the runner-up in a very competitive league. Football finished as Atlantic Bowl champions. Baseball was the regular season champions. And our boys basketball team won the 2022-23 championship, cutting down the nets immediately after that win. For your success on the playing field, I am proud. To my 6th and 7th graders, your journey as a Brave is not yet complete. You will, once again, have the privilege and honor of wearing the black and gold as a Brave. As you prepare for testing and summer vacation, take time for yourselves to reflect on the year that was and how to come back next year even better. Use your time off to improve your skills and prepare yourself for the fall. You have big shoes to fill, big expectations. That said, know that I care very deeply for all of you, and I'm looking forward to our time together next year. Lastly, and this might be tough, so excuse me, I want to speak directly to my 8th graders. I would be lying if I said this 8th grade class didn't have a special place in my heart, so this night is a little bittersweet for me. At the conclusion of this event, your time as a Brave will be over, and you will take your athletic talents to the high school. I know many of the high school coaches have already told me their excitement for this freshman class, and rightfully so. So many of you have unique talents and abilities. I would imagine many of you will be called upon to contribute to varsity level sports. I charge you with this: accept the challenge and know that you're capable of great things. Even as freshmen, you have the skills and dedication to make a profound impact. Work hard, set high expectations, and commit yourself to your goals. But most of all, believe in yourself and know that I believe very much in each and every one of you. To my eighth graders, good luck to you, thank you, and God bless you. It is now my great pleasure to introduce your master of ceremonies, the one, the only, Coach Levi Curls.
We're gonna have some fun tonight, fellas. Get ready. Oh, man. Thank you, everybody, for showing out tonight. Thank you, Mr. Edwards, for the kind words. Like he said earlier, welcome to the third annual Bravey Awards, and I'm your host for the rest of the night, Levi Curls. So 2 years ago, we started this Braveys, and we started this with just an idea because we had COVID for those eighth graders, and they missed out on a lot. So we really didn't know how it would go. We actually had no clue, and we just hoped for the best. But it ended up being great, so we kept it going. And some of you guys were there as sixth graders, and now you're here as eighth graders, and we wanted to do something extra special for you guys because y'all are a great group as well. So eighth graders, seventh and sixth graders, for the third time we've done this, you guys are by far the best dressed out of those 3 years. So give it up for yourselves. Two years later, man, we made it at the Pioneer Theater. We are officially big time, right? Still have no clue how it will go. Had no idea there was gonna be a wedding out there. They thought it was bad before, just wait till after, because we're gonna have wedding crashers too with these guys right here. Thank you so much to all the parents and everybody in the community that has basically put this event on and has gone out of their way to make it special for these kids, because that's really, when you get down to it, what it's all about. Thank you so much to the Pioneer for allowing us to be here tonight. Hopefully we don't destroy it on the first event. Special shout out to Aunt Jamie and Uncle David Hatchell, Uncle Michael Bassnight, and then Derek and Sharon Hatchell as well. It's a huge honor, and we're so thankful for you guys allowing us to be here and everything y'all have done to make this night spectacular for our athletes. They purchased the red carpet outside, they set up the star out front, and went above and beyond to make this night magical for you guys. So give it a round of applause for them. But wait, because we also have to shout out Vicky, Ava, Todd Horning, and Denise Pierce, because they had a big part in everything too. So thank all you guys so much for everything that you've done. It truly looks tremendous here inside and outside. I have to say a thank you to our administration team. We have the best one in the county by far, with Ms. Harper and Mr. Edwards for allowing us to, one, keep the Braveys going, and then for being there for you guys and everything that you do, whether it's school or on the field, on the court, whatever it is, they're always there for you guys. Special thank you to Mr. Edwards for taking over as athletic director, making sure this continued on and everything is possible that's here tonight. For looking out for our teams, our coaches, and our athletes all throughout the year. You're way better than the last guy that did it. Thank you to Mr. Brian. I know he gave him a shout out, but he really is. He's the most important man for the Braveys. He does everything behind the scenes. He doesn't want any of the credit, any certificate, anything on the screen. He set it all up, and he is responsible for all that. So, that's Mr. Edwards. He's the athletic director. He said, and the mistakes. So it's on him if anything goes wrong. So, Mr. Brian, thank you. Another thank you to Coach Alexander as well for being the doorman or security, if you will. And in the eyes of the Pioneer, you are by far the most important man of the night for keeping all those people out of here. No entry, no ticket, baby. Thank you to the parents for supporting our teams all year long and allowing your athletes to take part of the Braveys, for being out there at the red carpet, waiting for the wedding to finish, everything that you guys have done all year. We are extremely lucky to have community members like you guys that support everything that we do. And lastly, thank you to the athletes. You give yourself a round. Without you, none of this would be possible. Everybody behind you, everybody that was out here earlier, set this up for you guys so we could make you feel special and feel like the stars that you are. Tonight, we're going to do a lot of reflecting, a lot of looking back on this past year. We had a ton of success this year. Coach Edwards has already mentioned our basketball team won the conference tournament. That was the first since 2001. We can give them a round. That was good. Baseball team won the regular season conference championship. That was awesome. And then the softball team finished as the number 2 seed overall in their regular season and then ended up making it to the championship game. So give it up for those girls as well. All of our teams throughout the year got better. And really, as a coach, that's all you can ask for. One thing that I always want as a coach, and I tell all of my teams this, kids and parents, is to stay off of social media, especially after a game. That is not the case here tonight. We want you guys to take pictures. We got everything set up outside for afterwards. You can come up on stage after everything's done. And we want you to flood social media. Athletes, y'all get TikTok, Snapchat, Instagram. Y'all make it known that we were here tonight, and then parents, y'all hold down Facebook for us. I want kids that are from other schools and parents that have kids at other schools to see everything we've done here tonight, and I want them to be a little upset because they don't get to take part in it. For those of you that don't know, I know he already said it, but we are being live streamed tonight. And I had to use a lot of self-restraint right there to not make a sea hockey joke. Still doesn't sound right to me. So if you're not aware by now, tonight's going to be like the award shows that you see on TV. You got the Oscars, the Grammys, the ESPYs, and here at Manteo Middle School, we have the Braveys. The athletes for us are our celebrities in our building, so we want to treat them like that tonight, and we want them to have a special experience here so they fully understand that in our eyes and in everybody else's eyes, they are special and they are the celebrities to us. And I hope you guys get to feel like the stars that you are tonight. I don't think I'll have a problem with this, but I will need a little bit of crowd interaction tonight. I feed off of that. So, Nemo, you're allowed to clap. You're allowed to have a little fun. Athletes, we want you guys to cheer. We want y'all to celebrate. We want you to laugh, and we want you to participate because, after all, this night is about you, and we want it to be the best night of your life. Colton and Nemo, Y'all can even yell pause if you see the opportunity. Pause. Heard that a million times. JFJL, baby. So since we're talking about celebrities, I do think it's fitting that I just got back from L.A. I was out in Hollywood, and it's not a lie. I was really out there last week, or got back on Sunday this week, and I was out there to see my wife graduate from the University of Southern California, where she became a doctor of physical therapy. Y'all can give it up to her. She's in the gold back there. I'm super proud of her. However, I don't know who's more excited for her, though, me or the boys up here tonight. Especially Tanner. He's let me know how great she is for the last 3 years. But while I was at this graduation, all I could think about how perfect all the production was. The sound was perfect, the music was perfect, everything. On the big screen, everything was perfect. The main speaker was actually the president of Marvel Studios. So that's what they were working with. And for some reason in my mind, while I'm sitting there watching this graduation, I'm comparing what they're doing to the Braveys. So you got Marvel Studios, you got Manteo Middle School. We're essentially on the same level. But I got thinking, and in so many ways, if you love sports and if you grow up playing sports, the athletes that we look up to are basically like our superheroes. So kids look up to them. They really kind of copy everything that they do, especially celebrations. So when you teach or coach middle schoolers, you really learn all of the newest celebrations. I get this out of here. I gotta move around a little bit for this one. Can't do it? All right. So, first thing in football, when we started out, and you see it a lot in basketball too, if somebody went up top to catch a pass, you guys are allowed to say it out or do it. Head tap, head tap, head tap. That's all you see. Head tap. You know, on TV, with like NFL, college, when they head tap somebody, they actually catch it over top. When our guys do it, there's nobody within 5 yards. Except for Zay. Zay did get that kid from first flight. Kai was in there too. I'll give you that, Kai. So then basketball came along, and a lot of times in basketball, they make a move in the post or anything like that, and the first thing they do is after they make a basket, forget about defense, too small, too small, too small. And they just trot down the court doing this, looking back at their opponent. Half of them are looking back in the stands, making sure everybody saw it. The layups, they were against the air. Nobody near them. We spent, us teachers and coaches, probably spent about half the year wondering who he was or who's him. And then after half the year, we finally realized it was LJ. I'm him, I'm him, I'm him. We only realized it because he put it on his baseball glove. We saw rocking the baby to sleep. One of my personal favorites, the three ball. You got all kinds of stuff with that. Three, you had the goggles, all types of stuff with the three. And then in baseball, we even had bat flips. Hit a home run, throw the bat up. Or in our case, it was just a fly ball to right field. Nemo's a legend for that one. Get ready. But I really should have seen the celebration stuff, the celebration trend happening. And I should have seen it from our first football practice. It's something that, as a coach, as a player, watching football for 30 years, I have never seen before in my life. We had a certain player recover a fumble, and thank goodness it was in practice. And also, thankfully, Keontae, we do not need to see a demonstration up here tonight. I'm not allowed to talk about that one. Not only do these new celebrations and sayings by being around middle schoolers, we learn all that stuff, but you also learn a lot about yourself. So if you're a teacher or a coach, they let you know about yourself. They are not shy about telling you everything that they think is wrong with you. To be a middle school teacher or a coach, you really have to be a confident person. If they think it, they say it, and sometimes they're pretty mean about it. Gotta be honest. Thankfully, as you can tell, I'm wearing this jacket. I am a confident person, so I don't let it get to me. But I got some receipts here of what they've done to me in just this past year. So in just this year alone, I've been called short pretty much daily by all of these kids that are in attendance tonight. I mean, I'm 5'10", Jerry. 5'11", when I put shoes on, which is perfectly average. I might be 6 foot tonight with my hair up here. I can't help it. I stand next to giants every day, like Coach Alexander and Mr. Edwards. It's not my fault. For St. Patrick's Day this year, I wore a green shirt. Like, I'm trying to be festive. I wear green. It's St. Patrick's Day. Don't want to be pinched. First period, I walk in. First thing in the morning, I just hear, "Oh my gosh, you look like absolute trash when you wear green." Thank you for that one, Marley Archer. I remember it. Aubrey Muir told me I make her want to run away from school every single day. I still don't know what I did to make her feel that way, but it really hurt my feelings. For some reason this year, I've been accused a lot of dyeing my beard red. Red. Like, not my hair dark brown like somebody would probably think, but my beard red. And I hear that one at least once a week. Then they call me 50 years old because I have a beard. See a picture of me without one and say I look like a 12-year-old. There's no winning with these kids. Football and baseball players make fun of the way I run or jog because I'm flexible and sometimes it looks like I'm doing butt taps. And they joke on me about that. But I'm still faster than every single one of them. But it don't stop them. It does not stop them. And don't even get me started on the girls' basketball team. Don't worry, Doxie. You're safe. I'm not going to call you out about toilet paper in my house 6 times this year. The boys are ready. Excuse me, I said toilet paper. I meant toilet rolled. I woke up the next morning and I thought a Manteo did it. So one day at basketball practice, we had a lot of tension on the team, and I knew it was going to be a difficult practice. So I decided to wear my normal stuff, shirt, shorts, except for I wore socks, and I pulled them all the way up to my knees. And they were high. They were up to my knees. It did not look good. I knew this ahead of time. But every single one of these girls, they went 15 for 15, and they let me know that it did not look good. First, it was the facial expressions. They opened the door, and it's, "Oh, what are you wearing? Oh," every single one of them. And then you got the, "Oh, my gosh, does he think those look good? Why are they so high? He didn't even roll them." Learned about that, too, rolling your socks. But like I said, they were 15 for 15 on that. We didn't have a shooting average close to that this entire year. like I said, they weren't shy about it, and even Caroline LaRose let me know that they looked bad. Learned a valuable lesson that day. If you want to try a fashion statement or something, you want to see if something works, go walk in front of a middle school girls' basketball team. They will tell you if it's working or not, especially if it's bad. They just can't hide it. However, I do think that I finally cracked the code on an eighth grade girl's brain. So, yeah, unfortunately, it happened after basketball season. But sixth and seventh grade parents, if you have a girl back there, you need to listen up because this is gold. Whatever they say to you, whatever it is, they really mean the exact opposite. So, for example, every day in PE, I walk by Keely. And she sees me, and she knows I'm just going to ask her, and sometimes in a real chipper mood, I'll be like, Keely, how's it going today? And she'll look up at me, give me an evil eye, and look at me and say, it was great until you asked me that. Or, we got a little variation, it was great until you decided to talk to me. And every single day, I get just out of her sight, and she starts to smile. And I know she's having a good day then. When she says she's good, then I start to worry about her. Jasmine Cooper, she's the same way. Jasmine, a.k.a. Jazzy Fizzle. She's sinking in her seat because she says she hates that nickname, but she really loves it. She loves it. Every day in PE, she'll walk up to me and go out of her way to walk up to me and say, Mr. Curls, I just want you to know, nobody really likes you. And I'm like, that's fine, Jasmine. I don't really care. And then she says, well, I just want you to know, I don't really like you either. And I'm like, man, that's a little harsh. But then she proceeds to sit down right next to me and talk to me for the next 5 minutes. So, I don't know, if I don't like somebody, I typically try and stay away from them, and I don't seek them out and go talk to them every day. But, like I said, it's middle school girls for you, eighth graders especially. You got to take the opposite of whatever they say. A lot of times in middle school, boys and girls both, they tend to put up walls and they have their guard up, and it can be difficult as teachers and coaches to break those walls down. But once you do, it's really worth it. And sometimes teachers and coaches can have their walls or guard, whatever you want to call it, they can have their guard up as well. And the special group of athletes or students will break those walls down. And this eighth grade group has definitely done that. No matter if you want them to or not, they're going to act like they're your best friend. We'll get to Mr. Wheeler and email. So, I say all that just to say, I really think my dad likes Noah, Tanner, and Trevor better than he does me. And Noah, I understand because they're basically the same age. He's missing tonight for a fishing tournament, so if you thought I was lying, he's fishing right now. Drew and Nemo, they would stay about every day after baseball practice for about an hour, and they would just hang out and talk to me and Coach Wheeler. We couldn't get rid of them. They'd just hang out with us. But we kind of enjoyed it. We liked it. And Coach Wheeler especially loved that time with Nemo. Speaking of Nemo, him and Colton in Tomahawk Time have taken over me and Coach Alexander's office. They will not leave. They hang out there for A, B, and C. They're always there. One time they even ordered Uber Eats for us. JFJL, baby, they're always entertaining. I don't even know if I'm allowed to mention the trip that the baseball team took to Plaza Azteca. So, We went to Plaza Azteca after we beat Camden to win the regular season championship. Trevor hit a home run in the ninth inning, and the boys were on cloud nine. Asked them where they wanted to go after. We had all of them on the bus, and they said Plaza Azteca. We tried three tequilas first. They wouldn't let us in, but it was a good idea on their part. So anyway, we get to Plaza Azteca, and throughout the night, the entire team of our table of 18 people starts chanting, "Hey, hey, 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 hey," probably about five times throughout the restaurant. I'm embarrassed. I think that the restaurant's gonna throw us out, but everybody around us loved it. Don't know why, but they loved it. If you think I'm lying, the restaurant staff sang happy birthday to Colton three times that night. I mean, Johnny. And Colton, my man, was on top of the world, but I don't think anybody had more fun that night than Drew. But yep, never had a doubt, fellas. Conference champs, they can't take that one from us. So I say all of that just to let everyone in here know tonight that this great eighth grade group of athletes, both guys and girls, they are a really special group to us, and we're so proud of them for everything they've done. They're a lot of fun. They're also pretty funny as well. I'm probably going to laugh more than these guys sitting up here tonight. But I really know that they're funny because every now and then, and this is pretty rare, I'll see it about once a day, and it usually happens in an eighth grade PE class. So it's usually always the eighth graders. But every now and then, they'll even get Coach Alexander to crack a smile. Nemo and Colton especially. So we are going to tonight. Which one are we starting off with?
Trust, my friend.
Getting back to the awards, our next award tonight will be the Best Dressed Award, and these were basically voted on by the teachers that are in attendance tonight. Check yourselves out on the screen. I told y'all look good. Usually, we will have our student interviewer. We'll let them vote, and they get to take part in it, and they get to be a vote and decide who wins. But since Annie Miller did such a great job tonight, and she looks phenomenal, our winner for Best Dressed is going to be Annie Miller. Come on up, Annie. Annie, make sure you stay up here so you can get a pic with the best dressed male that we have. And the Bravey for best dressed male, Jerry Frazier. Now that we're on to the awards, our next award is going to be Female Outstanding Newcomer of the Year. This will be sixth grade athletes who contributed to the team throughout the year or even started, which is difficult because it's rare for most sixth graders to make a middle school team, much less contribute. And the nominees for Female Outstanding Newcomer of the Year are Camilla Himmelwright, Hurley Williams, Doxie Sulkowski. How'd I do saying it, Dox? I do good? And Zoe Melky. And the Bravey goes to Hurley Williams. It's impressive that she won, but it's even more impressive that she played half the year of basketball and the whole year of softball with a fractured back and didn't even know it. Now, the nominees for Male Outstanding Newcomer of the Year. Bentley Spencer. Y'all can clap every time. I don't care. I'm good with it. Trevor Dobson. Zayden Wheeler. Josh Brody. Jesus Hernandez Romero. And Sawyer Fleckenstein. And the Bravey goes to Trevor Dobson. He is not in attendance tonight because he actually had a travel ball tournament, so kind of fitting if he's going to miss. Our next event of the evening, we will introduce all of the teams. So we're going to call up, if you participated on a team, we're going to call you guys up on the stage. As you walk up, you will walk up here, take a picture. We'll read out all conference. We'll read out the coach's award, and Mr. Edwards will hand you the certificate. But once we call out the team and get them up here, just walk up on stage and make sure we get a picture of everybody that's in attendance for tonight. So our first team, our cheerleading team for 2022 and 2023. Y'all can go ahead and start walking up, and then I will read out everything that we have while y'all are walking. They were coached by Elizabeth DeHart. All-conference is Brooke Tillett, Ava Robinson, and Deja Brown. And the coach's award goes to Deja Brown. Make sure y'all get a picture in. Camera's right there.
There's the camera right there.
Coach DeHart was sad that she couldn't be here this evening, but wanted me to read this. It was one of the largest numbers that they had try out for cheerleading, and their team was compromised of 18 cheerleaders from 6th, 7th, and 8th graders. Over half the team were newcomers, and they all progressed really quickly. Several of them on the team had more reserved, quiet personalities, and they loved watching them gain confidence and courage in cheering in front of crowds. And then there were those who didn't have a problem with that, and she liked to call that the gift of loud. She's so proud of how the team pulled it together, even when things that they had practiced were changed an hour before games. And the team grew so much this year that she's eager to work with them all again next year. And congrats, ladies, on a great season. The next team we'd like to recognize is the 2022 MMS golf team. They were coached by Zach Alexander. All conference was Banks Foreman and Colin Godfrey. And the coach's award goes to Ryder Bennett. Coach Alexander, get up here and take a picture with him. Coach Alexander's recap of the year was, this year's golf season was a year of youth. We only had two returners and a ton of kids that wanted to play golf that never had. With that being said, they had a rookie set his personal best on two occasions and finished second in his first ever tournament. Another rookie who placed top five in his first ever tournament, and it was a fun year with a lot to look forward to and learn from next year. Thank you to all the parents who came out and supported and helped them find their golf balls and count their strokes. It's a golf term, Nemo.
Pause.
Gotta love middle schoolers. Next team is going to be the 2022 MMS football team. They were coached by Mark Mitchum and by myself, Levi Curls. All conference was Drew Brown, Zay Williams, Kai McGilberry, and Tanner Sawyer. And the coach's award goes to Colton Worrell. We finished the season with a 5-3 record and finished in third place. We ended on a 5-game win streak, and I think it's safe to say that we probably had the most passing touchdowns for an MMS football season. We ended defensively. We had 4 shutouts in 4 of the last 5 games, and it was a great group of guys, and we are so proud of the team that they continued to get better with each game that we played. The next team that we would like to honor is our 2022 MMS volleyball team, coached by Sabrina Montague, and their all-conference players were Doxy Sokowski, Easton Alexander, Jada Flowers, and the coach's award goes to Ava Drake. Volleyball had a great season this year. They finished 8-3, and one of the main highlights of their season was beating Camden and First Flight.
Good job, girls.
The next team we're going to recognize is the 2022 MMS soccer team. So soccer team, come on up here. They were coached by Mr. Brian Wehner and Ms. Diane Bognich. All conference for males, Anais Santiago Rayburn, Jordan Castiendo Ramirez, Logan LaRose, and Asher Warrender. The female all conference winners, Bailey Dickerson, Caroline LaRose, and Gabby Aguirre Gomez. The coach's award for soccer goes to Jacob Tredecki and Bella Huntingford. All right, we're going to get back to some awards now. Our next award is going to be Female Breakthrough Athlete of the Year. And to be a breakthrough athlete, you had to be in, you could be in 6th, 7th, or 8th grade, and you had to contribute major minutes this year after maybe not having a major role last year, or even for some of them, they may not have been on the team last year. So the nominees for Female Breakthrough Athlete of the Year are Aubrey Muir. Y'all can clap, I'm good with it. Keely Archbell. Sarah Jane Midget. Bella Huntingford. McKenna Gray. Kadrin Estrada. And Caroline LaRose. And the Bravey goes to Bella Huntingford. Great job, Bella. Next up, we have Male Breakthrough Athlete of the Year. And the nominees for that are Banks Foreman, Kai McGilberry, Trevor Sawyer, LJ Berry, Logan LaRose, Nicholas Jacqueline, Colin Godfrey, and Asher Werner. And the Bravey goes to Kai McGilberry. Kai was a finalist for Best Dressed as well. Look good, Kai. Looking good, buddy. Our next award is going to be Individual Performance of the Year. This award is for sports players that compete as individuals. They have teams and they're part of a Manteo Middle School team. But when they're in competition, they don't have their teammates alongside them and they compete on an individual basis. We had one athlete this year that excelled at his sport and ended up winning the conference tournament for the 98-pound weight class, I believe, in wrestling. And the winner of that Bravey goes to Cole White. Great job, Cole. Next up, we're going to recognize our winter sports. And the first team we're going to start with is our 22 and 2023 MMS girls basketball team. They were coached by myself and Miss Sabrina Montague. All conference players were Jasmine Cooper, Jada Flowers, and Bailey Dickerson, with the coach's award going to Petey Bateman. It was my second year coaching girls basketball, and I was very lucky to have Coach Sabrina help me along. And we finished 5-5, ended up in fourth place, but hosted a playoff game, which was one of our goals. They fought hard in every single game we played, and maybe sometimes a little bit too hard, especially when paper towels were involved. But we're super proud of them, and we'll miss the eighth graders that are moving up next year. The next team that we have is going to be the 2022-2023 Conference Tournament Champions MMS Boys Basketball Team. Come on up, fellas. They were coached by Dwayne Gibbs and Deshaun Banks. All conference was Zay Williams, Kai McGilberry, and Trevor Sawyer. And the coach's award went to Kai McGilberry. Coach Dwayne's recap was that they started with one goal in mind, and that was first place, and pointed to the tournament banner for men's basketball and decided that it had been long enough and that they were putting Manteo Middle School basketball up there this year. They masked the gash all season and accomplished that goal. Trevor, those steps might get the best of you, man. Those steps might be getting the best of you. The next team we're recognizing is going to be the 2022-2023 MMS Wrestling Team. They were coached by Michael Wilson and Charles Foreman. All conference goes to Cole White, Banks Foreman, and Leif Worth. And the coach's award goes to Jalen Roberts. The recap from their coaches were that they were a young team. They performed well, finishing the season with a 4-8 record. They had one conference champion, and they look forward to the upcoming season with high expectations. Great job, fellas.
And Gabby.
The next award we're going to go with is Coach of the Year. This award is for a team that got better from the beginning of the year to the end. This award is not about the best record, but the best coaching performance throughout the entire year. We are so thankful for all of our coaches and all of the work that they do for our athletes. The nominees for Coach of the Year: Coach Dwayne Gibbs. Coach Kaz Wheeler. Coach Melissa Gray. Coach Katie Spencer. and Coach Doxy. Who put that in there? And the Bravey for Coach of the Year goes to Coach Dwayne Gibbs. Again, this was the first time that our basketball team had won a championship since 2001, so this was definitely the man or the coach to win Coach of the Year. Hold that trophy, man. Get that trophy in there. This next award is a new award that we have added tonight. This is going to be the Character Award. This award can go a lot of ways because character can mean a couple of things. It can be what kind of person you are all the time when nobody's looking. But in this case, we have two athletes that I would really describe as characters. These two kids have kept teachers and coaches on their toes, especially this year. If you are in our building at all, you'll likely see these two walking together. They're probably going to have their hands on somebody, if not each other, and they're likely to be yelling, "Pause! Pause!" all the time. Also, what do you mean by that? These two keep their teammates and classmates laughing on a daily basis. We love these kids to death, and I think somehow in the last month, they may have become my best friends. Like I said, I really can't get rid of them. They stay in our office. So the Character Award for this year goes to Nemo Govan and Colton Worrell. JFJL, baby.
I think Coach Alexander needs to get up here too, because I don't know, they kind of look all the same right there, so they've all been hanging out together, so why not? Let's get one picture right there.
And for those of you that don't know, Nemo actually retired his own jersey yesterday. So he is truly a character. 21 forever. The next award is going to be the 2022-2023 Play of the Year. Our nominees for that are Cole White with the championship win. We have Zay Williams over the top with a head tap over a first flight defender to catch a touchdown pass. Softball has a double play where they made a double play in the infield and a double play on a relay from the outfield to get a runner out at home. Trevor Sawyer has a home run to win the conference, and it was a two-run home run in the top of the ninth inning of a game where the winner versus Camden would win the regular season conference championship. Keontae Daniels with an interception versus first flight where he intercepted the ball as a defensive lineman and it swung the momentum for our team in that game that we ultimately ended up winning. Alex Reyes with a hat trick. He scored a hat trick in the second half of a must-win game. And Solomon Cooper winning the mile with a win at the Curry Tuck meet on the hottest day of the season. And then Drew Brown with a grand slam versus Curry Tuck. Yeah, Drew! And here, actually, is the play. Maybe, maybe not. We don't have sound, but we do have the play.
Yeah, we need sound.
So, the Bravey goes to Trevor Sawyer with a home run to win the conference. Never had a doubt, Trevor. Next up, we're going to go with our spring sports. And first is going to be the 2023 MMS baseball team, coached by myself, Mr. Wheeler, and Pops, and my dad, Doug Curls, also helped out. All conference goes to Drew Brown, Nemo Govan, and Trevor Sawyer. And the coach's award goes to Gage Walston. We came in this year with high expectations and achieved almost all of our goals. We won the conference championship for the first time since 2016 and ended up with an overall record of 11-2. We hit 12 home runs as a team, and by the end of the year, it was one of the closest teams that I've ever been a part of. This group was special, and we will always have our memories at Plaza Azteca after the Camden game. Next up is going to be our 2023 MMS softball team. They were coached by Melissa Gray, Bruce Creef, and Henry Drake. All conference was Bailey Dickerson, Petey Bateman, and McKenna Gray. And the coach's award goes to Jasmine Cooper. Their season recap was a drastic overall improvement from the entire team in ability, execution, and attitude.
Yeah, that's Mr. Bruce. Real quick, this is for y'all know, this is going to be our largest eighth grade class. And these girls came together and did an awesome job. But with anything that goes on, there's always coaches that have to be out there with these girls. And, you know, a lot of things go on with that. So first, when y'all sitting out there at the games and you seeing Coach Gray do, there's a method to the madness. And when you see Mr. Bruce, he's the quiet guy. He just walks over. Nope, we're good to go, let's go. And so we use that as our tool to make these girls better. And they have improved drastically. Our goal this year was to compete for a conference championship. We pulled that off, and that's because these young ladies put in such hard work. So with that being said, the girls wanted to make sure the coaches.
We got two of them.
Yeah. That is Coach Gray, and for Coach Bruce.
We ain't gonna drop.
I'm an ugly crier.
Don't cry.
I'm an ugly crier.
man, they tape too much. There we go. They too much tape.
Look at that, Bruce.
Don't worry, too much tape.
There we go.
There we go. Pull her out there. Snatch off the other side.
Yeah, we're gonna break this thing, get it out of there.
There you go. Now snatch her out. There we go.
There you go, Mr.
And again, with this being said, they've given up, you know, family life, the whole nine. Me and Coach Gray and Coach Bruce probably talk on the phone about 4 to 5 hours every day on how to make the girls better. And so, again, thank y'all, Coach Bruce and Coach Gray, because at the end of the day, y'all make me want to be a better person. So appreciate y'all and all you ladies. Great luck in future endeavors.
Our next team that we're going to recognize is the 2023 MMS track team, coached by Katie Spencer and Coach Marcos, and all conference for those track. Y'all can go ahead and start walking up. All conference for boys was Alfredo Landazuri, Leif Worth, Joshua Domingo Ibarra, and for girls, all conference was Maya Blumenthal, Alexis Sullivan, and Sophia Cooper. The coach's award goes to Elliot Nunez and Cora Martin. The recap from the coaches was that they went into the season determined to turn the MMS track program around to both prepare students for high school track and help athletes reach their full potential. Sometimes they felt like they were coaching the senior games with all the ailments and aches and pains. But in the end, all of them showed up to practice and they and their meets prepared to give it their all. As coaches, they achieved their goals by encouraging students to work hard during practice, which paid off at the meets. And next year, a couple of seventh graders and eighth graders, they will know what to expect. It was an honor to coach them and to get to know this group of students on the MMS track team. Our next award is going to be our Volunteers of the Year. And everybody that is nominated is everyone that helped feed our teams or helped our teams in any way throughout this season. Our volunteers were so special this year, and the kids wouldn't get the experiences that they did if it wasn't for you all. Thank you to all the coaches, parents, bookkeepers, chain gang, and announcers, and any other volunteer job that I missed. Everyone that helped out was great for MMS, and we are so appreciative and thankful to have all of you guys. So from the bottom of our hearts, thank you for everything. Please stand up for a round of applause if you helped out in any way for any of our sports and athletes. You guys turn around and give a hand for all of the volunteers that helped you out. Stand up, volunteers. Come on now. They're shyer than the kids. We actually do have a winner, and it's going to be somebody special to me and a special volunteer that has been out here for the last 3 years. I've had the pleasure of coaching her son, who's a phenomenal athlete, but an even better person, and I know that she is a huge part of that. Coaching him was such a great experience for me because I felt like I was giving back and helping out the first cool teacher that I ever had. And that's for a core subject. Miss McGee, PE teachers are always cool. But this teacher, she just understood me and my friends. And she didn't scream at us when we were late to algebra every single day because we had weight training right before and didn't have time to change or cool off. She wrote a college recommendation for me, and on extremely short notice, she let me know that it was extremely short notice and I needed to give people more time, but she still wrote it, and she wrote it so I could get into her favorite university. Go Heels. She even put all of me and all of my boys in an Algebra 3 class, an honors Algebra 3 class that we had no business being in. And we all wondered why we were in it, and there was probably about 8 of us. We wondered why we were in it. We took our first test, and I think 7 out of 8 ended up getting like 30s on this test. The one person got extremely lucky. He bombed the next one. And then after that test, she met with us, and she told us that she was pregnant at the time with little Drew, and she would have to put us in a regular class, along with the honors class, just so she had the opportunity to teach us that semester. And she's done so much for the football, the basketball, and the baseball teams over the last 3 years, all while fighting her own fight. She means the world to me, has been so supportive for all of our teams and all of our athletes, and I can't wait to cheer beside her for the next 4 years. And our winner for the 2023 Volunteer of the Year, Miss Liz Brown. Come on up, Miss Brown. The next award that we're going to go with is the 2022-2023 Celebration of the Year. We had a lot of special moments and plays that led to some major celebrations throughout this year. The nominees for Celebrations of the Year are Keith Martin for wrestling, Jasmine Cooper for softball, LJ Berry for basketball, and Oliver Fifield for track. And the Bravey goes to. We can watch the video, but Jasmine Cooper with a walk-off in the 8th inning versus Perquimans. You can hear it in the sound. Give it up for Jazzy Fizzle.
Can't do it.
I don't know if we're allowed to do this next one.
It's your live stream.
I don't know if we're allowed to talk about Powder Puff. So a big sporting event that we did have this year that was new to Manteo Middle School was our Powder Puff game. And it will be one that I will remember forever. Miss Gallup had the bright idea to host the longest Powder Puff game in the history of all schools. We had two coaches and two referees that were on the field that night. I'm not including the players. Yeah, we can give it up for the cheerleaders. The cheerleaders did good, too. Y'all guys did great.
Cheerleaders, you're in the yearbook. Just get ready. Stop.
But the two coaches and the two referees that were on the field, Coach Alexander and I were the coaches, and Mr. Edwards and Mr. Bryan were the referees. The girls thought they did a great job. But between those three guys, every single one of them has college experience. They're all college athletes. And I was on the sidelines for every football practice and game at UNC in college. Every single one of us, after that game, agreed that the 2022 MMS Powder Puff game was the most intense game that we have ever been a part of. The girls played extremely hard, so hard that Petey broke her nose. But that didn't stop her, because she came right back in right after it stopped bleeding. Cabrilla RKO'd Doxy. Mr. Bryan hit her with a flag. Girls tied their flags to themselves so they wouldn't be able to pull them off. We had pushing, we had shoving, and I don't know if I'm allowed to say this, but we made it this far. We had a little bit of cussing going on the field as well. Jada, at one point, threw the ball at Mr. Edwards 100 miles per hour. Now, I'm not allowed to say where she threw it. But really, it was most intense on the last play when Annie hit Jasmine after an interception on the sidelines and completely hit-sticked her out of bounds, where she flies 5 yards and both teams just come together waiting for those two to clash. And luckily, Mr. Edwards, Mr. Bryan were on it, separated them, and they say nothing was going to happen. They were all good with it. But it was about to go down on that if they weren't there. So looking back now, everything worked back. And somehow, I think the girls enjoyed it and had a lot of fun. But the coaches and the refs, we probably have PTSD from it. But the girls showed out that night.
Should we call them up?
Sure, come on.
Any girls that took part in Powder Puff, y'all come up to the stage and y'all can get a picture. Cheerleaders and coaches can come on up too. Come on, guys. What? Bring everybody up here and take a picture. What are you doing back there, Kai? You help coach, man. You help me.
All right, got this pictures? I'll wait for Kai to get up. I've got to wait for Kai.
Yeah, he's a coach. Yep. Kai's actually a good coach.
We were good. We were great.
Getting penalties for our team. All right, there you go. Thank you, guys.
Thank you.
She hit her again? I think the MVPs that night were Mr. Edwards and Mr. Bryan. Girls, do y'all agree? Oh, I forgot. I forgot the other team paid them off in Powder Puff. The next award that we're going to go to is the Best Teammate Award. This award is for players that do what's best for the team and support the team no matter what the circumstances are. They are loved by their teammates and will do whatever the coaches ask them to do in order to help the team succeed. I've had the pleasure of coaching both of these winners and will miss seeing them every single day because not only are they great players, but they're great kids too. And the Bravey for Best Female Teammate goes to Bailey Dickerson. And while she's walking up, the Bravey for the Best Male Teammate goes to Gage Walston. Great job, guys. Way to be great teammates. This next award is another new award that we have added for this year. This award is for players that have tons of potential in the sports that they participate in. Sometimes you may see just a flash of how good they are, and sometimes you may see it for an entire game. But if they can ever figure it out how to compete at the highest level in the sports that they play, then the sky is the limit. And the Bravey for Female Sky is the Limit Award goes to Doxy Sokowski. And the Bravey for Male Sky is the Limit Award goes to Zay Williams. These next two awards that we have, unfortunately, are going to be the last two awards that we have for the night. And these two will be the Athlete of the Year awards. This is an athlete who is the best player on the team and deserving of an award. The winner will have to have had played multiple sports and have a major role on all the teams that they played on. The nominees for Female Outstanding Athlete of the Year: Bailey Dickerson, Jasmine Cooper, a.k.a. Jazzy Fizzle, Gabby Aguirre Gomez, Petey Bateman, and Jada Flowers. And the Bravey for Female Outstanding Athlete of the Year goes to Jada Flowers. Great job to all the nominees, and great job, Jada. Now the nominees for Male Outstanding Athlete of the Year. Drew Brown. Zay Williams. Jalen Roberts. Trevor Sawyer. Nemo Govan. Kai McGilberry. And Alfredo Landazuri. And the Bravey for Male Outstanding Athlete of the Year goes to Drew Brown. I want to say again, just we're towards the end now, a special thank you to everyone who helped put this evening together, to all the parents, the teachers, the pioneer who welcomed us and who decorated and put everything together for the Braveys. Thank you to our administration for supporting sports all year long and for being here tonight. Thank you to Mr. Brian for all the hard work that you put in for this and for helping me every step of the way. It truly would not be possible without you. Throughout the year, him and Coach Alexander have helped Manteo Middle School so much with coaching, running clocks, filming, or just filling in wherever they're needed. And we're truly lucky to have both of them at Manteo Middle School. And I'm extremely thankful for them. And just so thankful for all of the athletes and all the hard work that you guys put in throughout the year. And really thankful for the community that we live in, for putting this event on, and for allowing this to happen, and for everybody showing out tonight, and just for being there every step of the way for these kids, because at the end of the day, that's what it's all about. So thank you to everybody that had a part in tonight and for everything throughout this year. And I think we have one more award that Mr. Brian's gonna give.
Now, we didn't really have very many nominations on this one, but I do think we need to give, I think you won by default of this. So this has been a weird year, because Coach Curls, I've been here for 3 years, and Coach Curls came to me after my first year and said, let's do this. And it's been amazing. After this, Coach Curls had been our athletic director. He stepped aside. They came to me and said, no. Make a very long story short. So Mr. Edwards stepped up to the plate and pulled this off. So along with being our assistant principal, along with being our athletic director and holding this whole ship together, I just wanted to give you a thank you and have everybody else give you a round of applause. Thank you, sir, for everything that you've done. All righty, so I guess that makes it a wrap right there. We got a few pictures right there. If you got a Bravey, hold it up in your hand. Hold it up. Hold it up high. Hold it up high. All right, we're going to start. I see some back there. All right, here's what we're going to do today when we leave. And really quickly, because it's a tight area, but I've got this idea. If you got a Bravey in your hand, you're going to get to go first. And so everybody else that wants to take some pictures on the way out the door, you guys can take some pictures. And then, hold on, not yet, not yet. You know, it's like middle school. You got to wait until I say go. Like, it's one of those things. When you get out, you guys got to stay in the lobby until everybody else walks by. At least until your parents walk by. How about that? So get all your stuff. Once again, shout out to Coach Curls. Shout out to Mr. Alexander.
Security did a fine job. Nobody died. Thank you so much. We can't wait to do it again next year. Manteo Middle School Braves. Don't forget, like Miss Bonnie says, every day is a great day to be a... Thank you, and good night.